Good morning and welcome back. We are headed east today on the Canada's most boring highway, Highway 401 here in Ontario. We're heading to Toronto to pick up Nate at school. Sit back and enjoy the ride. This is typical for Highway 401. Not quite sure what's going on, but I'm sure we'll find out soon enough. We are backed up a long ways. Later, no apparent reason, we are moving again. Or are we about to stop again? I'm really not sure what's going on here. Yeah, they were just teasing us. We're back down to a crawl. I'm about to say at least we're not at a dead stop, but I shouldn't say that. I Maybe we'll find out soon enough what's going on. But there is a long line of cars, multi-miles of cars behind us. Multi-miles. Yeah, we'll go with that. Alright, we're moving again. Let's see for how long. Up to speed, moving again, and nothing. No collision, no stalled vehicles, no particular reason. We all just thought we'd just make the 401 a parking lot. Never fails. A few short kilometers down the road and we are crawling again. This time I think it's construction though. Last time, no reason at all. Looks like we're gonna have to make a lane change up here. We'll squeeze our way in here somewhere. About to run out of road. That kind truck driver was nice enough to let me in. The alternate route to get to Toronto is Highway 403, which is usually trouble-free. Just made a rhyme. Probably should have went that way instead of this way. It is what it is. We're committed now. Thinking I should have brought some snacks. We are just about to make our way through Kitchener. Yep, it's construction. This highway seems to be a never-ending make-work project. There is always construction somewhere. You gotta remember, I come from a small town of 4,000 people and two stoplights. Biggest traffic jam we got is the farmers in their tractors trying to get to Tim Hortons. guess we're all gonna hang out again just for fun. You can't make this stuff up. We'll hang out for a bit and then we'll get back to you. We have moved and came to a stop twice in the last, well, since the last time I checked in with you. From the looks of things, we're about to come to a stop again. You guys got highways like this in your area? Leave me a comment down below. The stop and go, this is pretty much why I don't come here. It just makes no sense. Like I said before, there's no reason for the stop. You get this many cars in one spot, and all it takes, I guess, is one person to hit the brakes, and that's accordion effect for the 100 cars behind them. And by the time you're the 101st car, you're sitting in a parking lot. Again, it doesn't make any sense. I've watched some videos about the worst drivers in the Toronto area. Yeah, there's some dingers up there. I'm sure we'll come across a few while we're there. And yep, we're gonna show them to you. Looks like we're moving. And there's the brake lights. Can't catch brake. Alright, I think we got the problem figured out. Now we're in the fast lane, going 87 kilometers an hour, speed limit's 100. See brake lights coming on. What I have noticed is that 50 cars in front of you, some of them will tap the brakes or put the brakes on, and then 48 cars behind that vehicle, that guy starts to brake, and then that just throws an accordion effect into everybody, and next thing you know, we're in a parking lot on a 401 for no reason. Sounds like I'm ranting, doesn't it? Maybe I am. Things are starting to get a little dicey up here. People are getting impatient, dodging in and out of traffic. You see off in the distance there on the right side, the ski resort. Well, lets you know that we are starting to get a little closer to Toronto. Never been there, but I hear it's nice. Truck here is trying to rear end the truck in front of him. of the transport trucks are jockeying for position. Never know what's going to happen. This truck here is going the wrong way. Well, not really. That is a cool looking tow truck right there. Joey's Towing out of Detroit, Michigan. You guys know how to paint a truck. Start coming into Milton right now. The left lane here is a carpool lane. You got to have two or more people in your vehicle. I'm not sure if that counts for multiple personalities or not. If it does, I might be able to run over there, but we'll just stay here for now. Start to see the Toronto skyline. Pearson International Airport is off to our left. We need to get over because we want the 427. Just try and do it without denting the fender, that's all. If you leave slightly more than a car length gap between the car in front of you, somebody's going to fill that hole. And here in Ontario, in many other places, it is illegal to use your cell phone while you're driving. You got to be hands-free. However, when you get to the major cities like this, there are digital signs all over the highways. We're coming up on a digital sign here. There's so much writing on this sign that I pretty much got to pull over just to read it all. Looks like you might want to brush up on your French too while you're here. So this sign is full, and the sign on the right says no texting or dialing, $615 fine. You might have to pull over to read all that. So we're going to take the 427 highway off of the 401 here. We're going to be heading towards Lake Ontario. I know you can't see it, but Pearson Airport is exactly on our left-hand side right now. City of Toronto, population 2.795 million people. 427 North. So you see the folks going to our left here. That's going to take you right to the airport. We want south. Anytime you can get to Toronto and back without denting your fenders, you're doing well. Mind you, we're not out of the woods yet. Probably shouldn't have said that. We're about to lose our lane here. Stay on this road. We're going to be looking to get off to Lakeshore Drive. If tradition continues itself, I miss this exit every time. So we'll see. Going to be our exit here. Doesn't say anything about Lakeshore Drive, but I think this is what we are looking for. Right, we're going to find out together. Tower's off to our left, but it is covered in fog. You can just barely see it. Something tells me that was not our exit. I'm sorry, we'll make it work. Into. Just fine. We're going to be looking for Lakeshore Drive. I'll get back to y'all in a minute. Lakeshore Drive. Yes, it is. All right, here's a question. We're going to go east or we're going to go west? Got a 50-50 shot. Let's go east. Lakeshore Drive heading east towards downtown Toronto. I believe this part right here is Mississauga. Again, I think we're going the right way. If y'all can't tell that I'm lost or not sure where I'm at, then I am. should be on the right up here. I believe this is it right here. Yes, it is. We made it. Without a problem. Well, minor problem. Well, we got Nate picked up back home now, and traffic coming home was nil. There was hardly anybody on the road coming back home, which made life a whole lot easier. But it kind of gave me less to complain about. Oh well, maybe next time. That's all I got for today's video. A little bit of a road trip. We got to do that once in a while. You guys all hit that subscribe button while you're here. We'd love to have you along, and we'll see you all in the next one. Later.